This Vellum node is super powerful. Let's jump into Houdini and check it out.
Vellum Grains. Vellum Grains is incredibly versatile. As it's really just points, you can do a whole lot with it. Let's take a look at how we can set up a basic Vellum Grain simulation and then dive into some additional examples to get control over our simulation. We'll start by creating a sphere. Let's change the primitive type to polygon. Let's reduce the uniform scale and increase the frequency so we get a slightly more subdivided sphere. Now we want to move our sphere up in the Y direction and move it a little bit forward in the Z direction. Now we're going to create a collider for our sphere or our grains to fall onto. So let's create a box and increase the size to 3 on X. And we're going to use a copy transform to create a stair-like pattern. So we'll give it 7 copies and we'll move it down in Y and move it forward in the Z direction. This looks great. Now we're going to create a Vellum Grains. As you can see, there aren't too many settings in the Vellum Grains. For now, let's use this Create Points from Volume checkbox. This fills whatever geometry we give it with a bunch of points. It shows it as spheres at the moment because it has the Sprite Materials checkbox checked. Let's plug in our collider into the third input of our Vellum Grains node. Next, we're going to add a Vellum Constraint node, and we're going to change the setting to be Glue. We'll leave everything at default for now, except we'll change the geometry type and the target type to points. We're going to have a look in a little bit at what these settings do and how we can manipulate them to give us a better result. Next, let's drop down a Vellum Solver. We'll increase the substeps to 4, and in the Collisions tab, we'll add a ground position and we'll move it below our steps. Let's hit play. Possibly this is what you're after, though that's unlikely. Let's take a look at how we can dial some settings to change the look and get a bit more control. As there aren't very many parameters on the Vellum Grains node, we're going to jump straight into the Vellum Glue node and see how some of these parameters can affect and influence our Vellum Grain simulation. If we just increase the constraints per point on the Vellum Glue, the grains are now glued to each other and they won't go flying off. So now we get a nice blobby goo. Just a side note, you can also point deform your original mesh to your points. This can give you some pretty cool results. You can also use a VDB from particles to get some nice fluid type mesh with a little bit of extra smoothing. We can also lower the stretch stiffness while maintaining the constraints per point in the Vellum Glue, and now the glue constraints are allowed to stretch a lot. You can also use a Vellum Attach constraint to constrain some of the points to the steps so they stick to the steps when they get within a certain distance. Another really useful feature when using grains is the cluster attribute option inside the glue constraint. This will create glue constraints within cluster groups, allowing you to get clumps that are glued together. You can also release grains by an attribute while maintaining the cluster group to get some really organic type of motions. Let's take a look at the cluster setup and how we can set that up. I started with a torus and I gave it a few more subdivisions, then I rotated it slightly to get a better angle. I then used a points from volume. The reason I use this over creating points in the Vellum configure grains is that I want to use the cluster node in between creating my points and the Vellum grains node. I then drop down a cluster node and I change the number of clusters. I then use a Vellum configure grains. I then copy and paste it as a relative reference to the point separation value into the grain size. I then added a Vellum glue. I checked the cluster attribute and I added 6 constraints per point, so each point was really clinging to the points around it. I did, however, add a slight detached point chance. This will randomly allow some points to break off, giving a nice sense of realism. I used a stretch stiffness of 10,000. I used a mop shape falloff to create a 0-1 attribute that I'll use to trigger my gravity. Mops isn't included in the native Houdini, however, this part is a free toolkit that you can install. I highly recommend it. If I dive inside the solver, I have a geometry angle. I'm going to use this to bring in the mops falloff. So in the input tab, I'll reference the null I created after my mops falloff. In the code section, I'm creating an integer called pt, which is the point number. I then use a point function to bring in my mops attribute. I then create an attribute called activate, which is equal to the mops. In order to get more control over a gravity force, I like to sometimes create gravity inside a popwind by adding -9.8 in the Y direction. In the expressions, I can use a simple expression to activate my wind only with my mops falloff. Let's take a look at one more thing that gives some great control. That's the Vellum attach constraint. This will attach our grains to a specified geometry. So in my setup, I added a grid. This will go in the third input of the Vellum solver. All my other settings are exactly the same. If I dive inside the solver, I add a new Vellum constraint set to attach. I changed the group type to points. I also set the target path to my third input. That's where I plugged in my grid. I then added a max distance so that only points that come within this distance are attached. Now when these points get too close to the grid, they stick to it. One final thing that's worth mentioning is a small, almost hidden checkbox that allows you to get some fun results. That's the Assume Uniform Radius checkbox. If you're using a Vellum solver on the SOP level, you can right click, allow editing of contents, and dive inside. Find the .NET, dive inside, and find the Vellum solver. Here we can go into the Advanced tab and look for the Vellum Grains Collision tab. There's a small little checkbox that allows us to uncheck Assume Uniform Radius. Now we can stipulate random piece scales, and the Vellum grains will solve multiple grain sizes. As you can see, Vellum Grains has a bunch of cool uses. Now it's your turn. Open Houdini, try it out. It's Houdini time.